Okay. Good afternoon. So basically, in yesterday's lecture, we discussed regarding what is heat balance sheet or heat balance sheet of an IC engine. Okay. Then, how different types of tests are carried out on the IC engine. Then, what is combustion occurs basically. Okay. How your actual combustion occurs. Means the stages in the combustion system. So first one, the propagation of first flame, then it will start your actual combustion process with predetermined time. What is pre-ignition, effect of pre-ignition, then what is detonation and how your detonation phenomena will occur. Okay. Our next topic is what is catalytic converter. So before starting, what is catalytic converter? There are some definitions regarding what is octane number and different types of number which is associated for your engine. So first one is the octane number. Okay. So basically, your octane number is measure of your knock resistance of fuel. We can say that the gasoline. Okay. So basically, we are going to use or we are using gasoline. Excuse me. So we are using gasoline as a fuel. So octane number is basically denoted to measure the knock resistance ability of your fuel. Okay. So it defines the numerical value of 0 to 100. Okay. And describe the behavior of fuel in engine during the combustion process. Okay, combustion process मध्ये तुमचं fuel हे कुठल्या कुठल्या वेने बिहेव करतंय ही ability तो describe करतोय by defining the number. Okay, एक numerical value असते. Okay. So your high octane number can help to increase the efficiency or we can say that increase the performance of engine. Okay. But your octane number does not measure your energy content and the performance of your combustion system. Okay. Means whether combustion system or combustion is 100% or not. Or good or not. Okay. So better performance can be measured or can be achieved by adjusting various parameters of an engine. Okay. Or various parameters of any fuel. Okay. Just to engine performance increase karne, so octane number increase karne, haa te parameter nahi. Tar tumcha engine che kiwa engine fuel che aankhi kai parameter asta. So by changing those parameter, we can increase basically the performance of an or efficiency of an engine. Okay. So for that research purpose, there is another term came into picture like research octane number. RON, research octane number. Okay. So your research octane number is described the behavior of fuel in the engine at lower temperature with the lower speed. When your speed of an engine is low and temperature of an engine is low again. So at that time, how your fuel will behave. Okay. So this is practically done for the research purpose. Next one is your motor octane number, MON, motor octane number. So when your engine is at a high speed with the high temperature, at that time, or we can say that the fast driving on the highway with the high speed and after achieving the high temperature of an engine. So at that time, how your fuel will be behaving, it shows your motor upcoming. Okay, so this motor octane number is generally not a customer or not useful for a customer point of view. Then next one is your knock resistance ability. What is knock resistance? Your knocking is generally or detonation is generally is the phenomena because of pre-ignition, or we can say that once your temperature reaches at the higher work or higher level, due to this, your fuel can converted into vapor and they collapse on the internal side of an cylinder. So because of that, the knocking is created. Okay, so knock resistance means when we create the air fuel mixture in such a way that it will ignited only by injection or ignition by the spark. Okay, so tumcha स्पार्किंग मुळे नाही तर कॉम्प्रेशन मुळे पण इग्निशन व्हायला पाहिजे अशी जी एअर फ्युएल मिक्सरची प्रॉपर्टी असते इट इज कॉल्ड एज युअर नॉक रेजिस्टन्स एबिलिटी. ओके, सो कमिंग बॅक टू अवर टॉपिक दॅट इज कॅटालिटिक कन्व्हर्टर. सो कॅटालिटिक कन्व्हर्टर इज बेसिकली द एक्झॉस्ट इग्निशन अँड कंट्रोल सिस्टम. ओके, so your when we consider the pollution created by your automobile, it is classified or divided into two categories. So first one is the non exhaust pollution and the second one is the exhaust gas pollution. Okay, non exhaust pollution and second one is the exhaust gas pollution. So what is non exhaust pollution? So non exhaust pollution is the because of evaporation of fuel or evaporation of your hydrocarbon. Okay, so basically without combustion process, combustion hone aadhi je kai fuel kiwa je kai hydrocarbon he evaporate hota. So basically because of high temperature your petrol which is present in the fuel tank or the carburetor, okay, is evaporate and mix in the atmosphere. So this type of pollution is called as your non exhaust pollution. Combustion karat nahi mhanje fuel tumka gas fuel kiwa exhaust madhe convert karat nahi he directly tumhi jar fuel tank open thevli फ्युअल टँक ओपन ठेवल्यानंतर जे काही तुमचं फ्युअल असेल ते काही व्हेपर मध्ये कन्व्हर्ट होतं आणि डायरेक्टली अटमॉस्फिअर मध्ये मिक्स होतं. दिस टाइप ऑफ पोल्युशन इज कॉल्ड एज युअर नॉन एक्झॉस्ट पोल्युशन. ओके, सेकंड वन इज एक्झॉस्ट गॅस पोल्युशन. एक्झॉस्ट गॅस पोल्युशन, सो व्हॉट इज एक्झॉस्ट गॅस पोल्युशन? इट इज बेसिकली कम्प्लिटली अपोजिट टू नॉन एक्झॉस्ट पोल्युशन. So your exhaust gas pollution is occur because of combustion of fuel. Fuel cha combustion zalyamule je kai exhaust va je kai pollution tayar hota zala tumcha exhaust gas pollution. Okay, so the main gases or main constituents in the exhaust gases like your nitrogen oxide, okay, then nitric oxide. So your nitrogen oxide is relatively low, okay, and your nitric oxide or nitrogen oxide combinedly called as the oxide of nitrogen, you know it. Okay, so when we conduct the PUC test, on that slip those parameter are mentioned NOx is the parameter which is also mentioned in that particular emission receipt, NOx. So NOx basically the combination or the oxides of nitrogen in which your nitric oxide and nitrogen oxide may present. Okay, then carbon monoxide, CO. And your unburned particle of hydrocarbon. Okay, means tumcha engine emission madhe teen basic parameters astat. First one, oxide of nitrogen, NOx. Then carbon monoxide, CO. And unburned hydrocarbon, CH. Okay, so all these pollutants are due to the composition of fuel and air and their combustion and resultant reaction of an after the combustion process, resultant reaction after the combustion process. Okay. So if you consider the first parameter, that is carbon monoxide, and if you see the properties of carbon monoxide, so your carbon monoxide which is generated by the vehicle, it is basically colorless, it is toxic gas. Okay, so if you consider the 0.3% of carbon monoxide in the air can create serious damage within 30 minutes. Okay, when the this particulate in the air may present more than 300 ppm, that is 300 parts per million. Ek million mane jar 300 pekcha jaast jar part asel tar to person la serious damage karu shakto. Okay, second one is your nitrogen oxide. It is again colorless. Okay, then when we mix with the atmospheric oxygen, it will become the reddish color or reddish brown color and form the nitrogen oxide. Okay, this is again toxic. When it will reaches more than 1500 ppm, it will cause the damage of respiratory system. Okay, it will create or damage the lung tissue. Then next one is the oxide of nitrogen. Oxides of nitrogen may consider as nitrogen oxide or your nitric oxide. The two can combination karun kiwa summarize karun mi nitrogen oxide tyamadhe add karto. So just a minute. Okay, so nitrogen oxide. So again, your oxide of nitrogen, that is mixture of nitrogen oxide and nitrogen dioxide, may damage your organ when it will go upper level than the prescribed limit as per suggested by the government. Okay, then unburned hydrocarbon. Okay, so hydrocarbon is the substance which is required for the combustion process, but the unburned hydrocarbon, when your combustion not completed by completed 100%, then some amount of hydrocarbon is again mixed with your flue gases so that it will pollute the environment. So this unburned hydrocarbon created because of compression or combustion, which when your flame of propagation not reaches at its prescribed volume, jee jee kay flame aste first combustion flame, ti purna propagate jar jhali nahi, purna burning jhali nahi, tar tyamadhe je kay fuel che molecule asta te molecule will leave during the expansion and your exhaust stroke. Okay, then when your cylinder or when your engine is in cold starting condition, like in winter season or in rainy season, basically ज्या केस मध्ये तुमची व्हेकल ही कोल्ड स्टार्टिंग मध्ये असते, म्हणजे बघा तुमच्या रेनी सीझन मध्ये किंवा विंटर सीझन मध्ये आपण भरपूर क्रँकिंग करून म्हणजे किक मारतो, म्हणजे क्रँकिंग करतो, क्रँकिंग करून किंवा इग्निशन ऑटो करून तरी व्हेकल स्टार्ट होत नाही, कारण तुमच्या इंजिनचं जे काही टेम्परेचर आहे ते टेम्परेचर हे कमी झालेलं असतं. सो एका सर्टन एक्सटेन नंतर इंजिन हे नॉर्मल टेम्परेचरला आल्यानंतरच तुमचं ऍक्च्युअल कंबशन प्रोसेस स्टार्ट होतो. सो त्या रिझन मध्ये तुमची इंजिन वॉल ही कूल झालेली असते किंवा सिलेंडर वॉल कूल झालेली असते. ओके, मग त्या केसमध्ये जे काही मॉलिक्युल हे आतमधल्या साईडला असतं ते बर्न होतात, बट द मॉलिक्युल विच इज प्रेझेंट ऑन द इंजिन वॉल मे नॉट बी बर्न कम्प्लिटली. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट अगेन सम अमाऊंट ऑफ पार्टिकल ऑफ युअर हायड्रोकार्बन मे प्रेझेंट which is in unburned form, which create again the unburned hydrocarbon. Okay, then other particulates like your sulfate, lead and soot. Okay, so lead is the particle which is again present in the petrol. So basically 0.15 milligram amount of lead is present in 1 liter of petrol. Okay, so lead is a compound which under petrol compound jar bagitla don type che fuel bhetta, ek normal asta ani ek power fuel mhanto apan tela power booster kiwa power petrol mhanto. Power petrol madhe tumcha lead cha je kay amount asto ti kami jhalele aste. So it can give the better result. Okay, so similar to this, your diesel engine also generates some amount of pollutant like your nitrogen oxide, hydrocarbon. Okay, then soot, or we can say that smoke. आयदर तो व्हाईट स्मोक असेल किंवा ब्लॅक स्मोक असेल किंवा ब्लू स्मोक असेल, ज्या टाईपचा स्मोक हा तुमच्या इंजिन थ्रू बाहेर पडतो त्यानुसार तुमची इंजिनची कंडिशन हे ठरत असते. जसा डॉक्टर आपल्या विंड किंवा डोळ्यांवरनं कलरवरनं तो पर्सनला कुठला आजार झाला असेल तो डिस्क्राईब करतो, त्यानुसार तुमच्या इंजिनचा स्मोक कसा येतोय त्यानुसार तुमची इंजिनची कंडिशन हे ठरत असते. फॉर एक्झाम्पल जर व्हाईट स्मोक जर कन्सिडर केला तर व्हाईट स्मोक जर तुमचं इंजिन हे लो टेम्परेचरला रन होत असेल, ओके, आणि तुमच्या इंजिनच्या फ्युल इंजेक्शन सिस्टीम आणि ऍक्च्युअल कंबशन प्रोसेस मध्ये जर जास्त टाइम लॅग होत असेल तर व्हाईट टाईपचा स्मोक हा तुमच्या सायलेन्सर थ्रू बाहेर पडतो. ओके, कधी एकदम स्टार्टिंगला बघा ज्यावेळेस आपण गाडी ही चालू करतो त्यावेळेस फक्त व्हाईट व्हाईट स्मोक बाहेर पडतो, नंतर रेग्युलर वेने स्टार्ट होतो. ओके, म्हणजे त्या केस मध्ये इनिशियल स्टार्टिंगला तुमचं इंजिनचं टेम्परेचर लो असतं, म्हणजे ऑपरेटिंग टेम्परेचर हे कमी असतं. ओके, आणि तुमच्या फ्युल इंजेक्शन मध्ये आणि ऍक्च्युअल कंबशन मध्ये हा काही लॅक असतो, त्या लॅक मुळे काय होतो व्हाईट स्मोक हा तयार होतो. सो जनरली नॉट अ सिरियस कंडिशन, सो वी जनरली इग्नोर दॅट. ओके, एक व्हाईट स्मोक बाहेर होतो, नंतर रेग्युलर तुमचे इंजिन स्टार्ट होतं. सेकंड वन इज युअर ब्लॅक स्मोक. ओके, मग त्यामध्ये तुमचे काही जर सूटचे पार्टिकल एक्झॉस्ट गॅस मध्ये रिझल्ट असेल किंवा प्रेझेंट असतील किंवा इनकम्प्लीट कंबशन झालेलं असेल, ओके, तर त्या किंवा तुम्ही हाय ऍक्सलरेशन देत असतील, ओके, हाय ऍक्सलरेशन देत आहे किंवा हेवी लोड कॅरी करताय, त्या केसमध्ये तुमचा ब्लॅक स्मोक हा बाहेर पडतो. आणि ब्ल्यू टाईप मध्ये जर बघितला तर ब्ल्यू टाईप मध्ये जर तुमचं लुब्रिकेटिंग ऑइलचं जर कन्झम्पशन फास्टर रेटने होत असेल किंवा तुमचं म्हणजे आपण जे काही लुब्रिकेटिंग ऑइल युज केलं असेल ते कन्झम्पशन हाय रेटने होत असेल तर ते तुमचा ब्ल्यू स्मोक हा बाहेर पडतो. आणि जर ब्ल्यू स्मोक जर तुमचा सायलेंस बाहेर पडला, इट इज द सिरियस डॅमेज ऑफ युअर इंजिन, म्हणजे इंजिनची कंडिशन खूपच पुअर आहे. ओके, सो टू मेजर द एक्झॉस्ट इमिशन और टू रिड्यूस द एक्झॉस्ट इमिशन कॅटलिक कन्व्हर्टर इज यूज. ओके, सो कॅटलिटिक कन्व्हर्टर इज अ डिवाइस विच कन्व्हर्ट द हार्मफुल गॅसेस इन टू हार्मलेस गॅसेस. So basically there are two types of catalytic converter. First is two way catalytic converter and second one is three way catalytic converter. So basically let's discuss about what is the principle of general catalytic converter. Okay, so your catalytic converter is basically placed between your exhaust manifold and silencer. Tumcha engine cha exhaust manifold jo asto ani silencer yacha aat madhe प्लेस केलेलं असतं. ओके, प्लॅस्टिकची पॅलेट असते ती तुमच्या कॅटलाइट किंवा कॅटलाइटिस्टने कव्हर केलेली असते. ओके, सो बेसिकली इट इज डिझाईन फॉर द ऑक्सिडेशन विच इज क्रिएटेड बाय द इंजिन ऑर पोल्युटंट विच इज क्रिएटेड बाय इंजिन विच make trapped inside the system so that we can convert it into harmless gases. Okay, so when we consider the amount of temperature which is required for the better combustion, so when we see regarding the bulk gas oxidation and to reduce the hydrocarbon gases or carbon monoxide or oxygen of nitrogen, we require temperature of 600 to 700 degrees Celsius. Okay, so but temperature of exhaust gases in the exhaust system is lower than this temperature. Okay, so the catalytic converter basically oxidizes and reduces all the three pollutants like your hydrocarbon gases, carbon monoxide and oxide of nitrogen at the lower temperature. Okay, because of your catalytic chemical reaction. So generally we require temperature of 600 to 700 degrees Celsius, but this process will manage with the help of device called as catalytic converter. So your catalytic converter convert this oxidizes and reduce the pollutant with the lower temperature. Okay, basically it is work in between of 250 to 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, so basically there are two types of catalytic converter. First one is the two way catalytic converter. Okay, as you can see in the picture, so this converter is filled with the substance like your platinum and palladium. Okay, so this is the honeycomb structure of platinum and palladium, like mesh type of structure as well. So your platinum and palladium will convert chemically convert your carbon monoxide hydrocarbon into carbon dioxide and water. So this is type of your catalytic, a two way catalytic converter converts two gases. Three way catalytic converter convert all three gases into harmless gases. Okay, tumche two way catalytic converter tumche fakt carbon monoxide ani hydrocarbon he dono tumche conversion sathi use karta. Okay, so this is the two way catalytic converter. हायड्रोकार्बन एनएक्स आणि सीओ हे तिन्ही गॅसेस पास झाल्यानंतर फक्त दोनच गॅसेस तो युज करतो. पहिला असेल तुमचा कार्बन मोनॉक्साईड आणि दुसरा असेल हायड्रोकार्बन. एनॉक्स सोडून देतो आणि हे मी कन्वर्ट करतो ह्या पॅरामीटरमध्ये. ओके कार्बन मोनोक्साइड मध्ये. सो बेसिकली एट दिस पोर्शन युअर कॅटलाइट कन्वर्टर इज प्लेस इन बिटवीन युअर सायलेंसर एंड एक्झॉस्ट मॅनिफोल्ड. ओके so basically it consists of the cylindrical unit okay installed between exhaust system of the vehicle placed between your exhaust manifold and the silencer. Okay so inside this cylindrical tube there is honeycomb structure okay ceramic ka asel kiwa metal ka asel which is coated of aluminum based material the primary coating asel. ओके आणि सेकंडरी कोटिंग असेल तुम्हाला सांगितलं तर एक प्लॅटिनम असेल किंवा रोडियम असेल त्यांचा तो कॉम्बिनेशन असेल. ओके आणि दिस सेकंड वन कोटिंग इज कन्सिडर ऍज युअर कॅटलिस्ट. ओके आणि हा सेकंड कोट जो असतो हा सेकंड कोट तुमचा केमिकल रिएक्शन मध्ये युज करता सो दॅट वी कॅन कन्वर्ट ऑल दी पोल्युटंट इन टू हार्मलेस गॅसेस. ओके सो व्हेन युअर एक्झॉस्ट गॅस पास थ्रू दी कॅटलाइटिक कन्वर्टर there is chemical reaction between the rhodium which acts as a reduction catalytic converter of NOx. So this convert your nitrogen into or start your oxidation process chemically. Okay so basically in through a catalytic converter we use the platinum and palladium as a oxidation agent so that it will convert your Hc into H2O and CO2 or CO into CO2. Carbon monoxide pasna carbon dioxide tayar hoto. Okay so this is how your catalytic converter look like. Ek honeycomb sarkha structure asto kya madhun tumche gas mhanje madha sarkha tamadhun tumche gas pass hota at the same time तुमची केमिकल रिएक्शन पण त्यामध्ये होते. ओके अँड दिस इज द थ्री वे कॅटलिटिक कन्व्हर्टर. सो दिस कॅटलिटिक कन्व्हर्टर यूज ऑल द थ्री गॅसेस or three pollutant. Okay so in first stage your rhodium reduce your NOx to nitrogen oxygen. In second stage your platinum and palladium act as a oxidation catalyst and change Hc and CO into harmless water and CO. So let's see by animation how it actually works. This is the engine. At this portion the catalytic converter is placed. This is the muffler. This is your exhaust tail. So this is the MPFI system. All the exhaust is assembled at the same point from all the cylinder. Main sarva char cylinder se exhaust me ek point matlab ise collect karto. It will pass through this catalytic converter these are the oxides of nitrogen carbon monoxide and hydrocarbon which are harmful. This is the honeycomb structure platinum rhodium then ceramic block. Ceramic block in between them is platinum and rhodium. So this mesh structure and absorb all the harmful gases and chemically converted it into harmless gases. So this oxygen compound gets separated and nitrogen gets separated. So this, after the chemical reaction, it will pass through the next level. Okay. Nitrogen, oxides of nitrogen is separated from oxygen and nitrogen. नंतर ते तुमचं प्लॅटिनम आणि प्लॅडियम सोबत रिएक्ट होता. कार्बन मोनॉक्साईड अँड ऑक्सिजन. ओके, आधीच्या स्टेज मध्ये जो काही तुमचा ऑक्सिजन सेपरेट झालेला होता तो ऑक्सिजन आणि CO हे दोघं केमिकली कंबाइन होऊन कार्बन डायऑक्साइड फॉर्म करतात. जो ऑक्सिजनचा पार्टिकल आलेला होता तो आणि कार्बन मोनॉक्साइड हे दोघेही कार्बन डायऑक्साइड फॉर्म करतात. अँड हायड्रोकार्बन प्लस ऑक्सिजन इज फॉर्म युअर वॉटर मॉलिक्युल अँड कार्बन डायऑक्साइड. The temperature of exogenous is such a high that your water is get converted into vapor again. Okay, so after the catalytic converter, after the conversion of all the harmful gases, harmful gases into harmless gases, it passes through the tailpipe towards the silencer. Okay, but these gases are now pollution free but having high noise, so these sound waves are again minimized in the silencer. Okay, in the silencer mhanje muffler basavlela asti the je muffler tumcha awaz kami karto. Okay, so this is the muffler. त्यामध्ये तुमचा इंजिनचा आवाज हा कमी होतो, म्हणजे एक्झॉस्टचा आवाज हा कमी होतो.
Hello.
Okay.
Thank you.